Hi again, Doug Stewart with IT Creations. I know how much you guys like GPU servers, and today we have the Supermicro GPU SuperServer 420GP-TNAR Plus with 8 SXM form factor NVIDIA A100 Tensor Core GPUs. That's right, 8 high-performance GPUs in a 4U chassis. It's more like a little cabinet you might find at IKEA with all those little drawers. If you like our channel, hit that subscribe button. Just know that I understand your hesitancy with that request. So let's get to it. Now, what can this Supermicro GPU SuperServer 420GP-TNAR Plus computational powerhouse be used for? Definitely AI and deep learning. Certainly you can use it in some high-performance computing as well. Bitcoin mining? Yes. Scientific simulations? Most definitely. There's actually a TNAR version without the Plus, but there is only a very minor difference, which we will get to. Cliffhanger? Not really. Anyways, features dual third-gen Intel Xeon scalable processors and is compatible with Intel Optane 200 series memory modules for up to 12 terabytes of memory. Now that IKEA reference, this system has 3 main drawers, 2 on the front housing the 1U compute node on top and the 3U GPU node on the bottom with the 4 integrated 9-centimeter fans. There's also a switch tray for some low-profile PCIe slots. Back to the front, the lower drawer has locking screws that you will need to remove before you can pull down on the levers to either side of the chassis to release the safety locks on both sides. The top compute node has a locking screw, and then you can pull the levers to either side out. Starting from the top left, a small control panel with telltale lights for general information for system status, network interface controller, unit ID, and the UID button at the bottom. Then a power on button, baseboard management controller reset button, 2 USB 3.0 ports, BMC LAN port, and a VGA port. Are you interested in the Supermicro GPU SuperServer 420GP-TNAR Plus? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the list price or one that you can configure using our handy configurator tool that's valued at $5,000 or more. I think the directions might be a little more complex than what you get from IKEA, but who actually uses those anyways? I placed the link right there and in the description below so you can do a little more research or even configure a system. Now, where was I? The 6 hot swap drive bays are all hybrid bays that can be outfitted with Gen 4 NVMe, SAS, or SATA drive types, depending on your workload. That said, if you do go SAS, you will need an HBA controller. Next to the drive bays, 2 PCI Gen 4 by 16 PCI slots, one to CPU 1 and the other to CPU 2. Below, 4 9-centimeter fans. Around back, the other removable drawer is the switch tray for the PCI slots. As this is a dual-root system, the PCI slots are divided between the 2 processors. Those 5 slots on the left map to CPU 1, and the other slots to the right map to CPU 2. I will mention that slot on the far left is an advanced I/O module, aka an OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot. For managing the system, Supermicro offers a few software utilities, including Supermicro SuperCloud Composer, Supermicro Server Manager, or SSM, and Supermicro SuperDoctor 5. There are a few others for updates, diagnostics, and automation. The Supermicro Server Manager is the all-in-one utility for managing multiple generations of Supermicro servers from a single console. However, you will need licensing software for each target node you want to access, and that number can be up to 10,000 nodes if you're using Linux. That said, SSM is compatible with several generations of Windows Server 2, including 2022. There is also a Supermicro IPMI tool suite for basic system configuration and updates using a command line interface or graphic user interface. A number of plugins are also available for use with VMware vCenter, Microsoft System Center Operations Manager, and Nagios. For local host monitoring, there's SuperDoctor 5, which is more of a one-to-one management utility. Each processor has a separate bus, so any expansion cards accesses one of those CPUs directly, and the CPUs then communicate between each other via the Intel UltraPath Interconnect, or UPI. You might notice on the back of the system between the PCI slots, there is a panel of 12 switchboard LEDs. Below all that, 4 PSUs. In this case, with the TNAR Plus, the PSUs are redundant 3000 watt titanium rated. On the TNAR without the Plus, the PSUs are 2200 watt platinum rated PSUs. At this point, I was thinking perhaps the GPUs on the Plus are 80 gigabyte and those on the other are 40 gigabyte, but no, both platforms support the 80 gigabyte GPUs. And let's take a look at those GPUs. Once we remove the 3U GPU node, you can see those large fans pulling fresh air into the chassis. Then a bank of 6 PCI switches and then the 8 SXM form factor NVIDIA HGX A100 80GB GPUs in all their glory. Well, at least the towering heat sinks on top of the cards. Air shrouds to either side ensure air movement over and through the GPUs, then out the back of the chassis. There are six PCI switches controlling the traffic between the CPUs and GPUs, potentially NVMe storage up front too. The GPUs themselves are connected via NVSwitch and third generation NVLink at about 600 gigabytes per second, at least for this generation. NVLink speed has basically tripled with fifth generation NVLink technology at up to 1,800 gigabytes per second. Lastly, I will say that no, NVSwitch is not the same as those PCIe PLX switches as it offers much higher bandwidth and lower latency. Also proprietary to NVIDIA. Let's move on. The NVIDIA HGX A100 GPUs are designed to handle massive data sets and are powered by Ampere architecture. Designed for data center applications, NVIDIA says it provides up to 20 times higher performance over the previous generation. Of course, it's now about 5 years old and two generations removed from Blackwell, which made its debut just a few short months ago at the end of 2024. That said, the A100 can still deliver a memory bandwidth of over 2 terabytes per second using HBM2E memory, a 1.7 times improvement over the previous generation. It was originally billed as the world's fastest, but not anymore. As a comparison, with Blackwell, memory bandwidth has increased to 4 terabytes per second. There are actually two form factors for this GPU, the SXM form factor supported on this system and a PCIe version. I won't bore you with the details, but suffice it to say, the SXM version does offer slightly better performance on that memory bandwidth at 2,039 gigabytes per second compared to 1,935 gigabytes per second, but also higher power consumption at up to 400 watts compared to 300 watts on the PCIe card. That's about it. Well, also you can only connect two PCIe GPUs using an NVLink bridge. Both do still provide 7 MIGs or multi-instance GPUs at up to 10 gigabytes per instance. Each of those instances behaves like an independent GPU, so you can run smaller workloads simultaneously. MIG provides a secure environment for multiple users or customers, allowing the ability to scale resources as needed. Now that 1U compute node, it also has the drive bays and two PCI slots on the far right. Our unit was outfitted with two 1.6 terabyte NVMe U.2 SFF drives and a single 1.92 terabyte NVMe U.2 SFF drive. This unit connects to that GPU node via those PLX switches. The compute node has dual sockets that can be outfitted with third generation Intel Xeon scalable processors with 8 to 40 physical cores and 16 to 80 virtual threads each. Those CPUs feature 8-channel memory architecture with 16 memory module slots per CPU and 32 active memory module slots with both processors installed. Supported memory includes ECC registered or load-reduced DDR4 DIMM modules. Using RDIMMs or LRDIMM memory, the system can deliver up to 8 terabytes of memory. Also compatible are Intel Optane Persistent Memory 200 series for up to 12 terabytes when combined with DRAM, as Optane memory is installed one module per memory channel. The other memory module slots can be outfitted with registered DIMMs. Memory speeds are variable depending on the CPU installed, the actual memory module, and the memory configuration, all of which can impact memory speed. CPUs in the Platinum and Gold categories offer the fastest memory speeds at up to 3,200 megatransfers per second compared to Silver, which tops out at about 2,667 megatransfers per second. Aside from the memory speed supported by the CPU and actual memory modules, peak memory speed is achieved with one DIMM per channel. With Intel Optane Persistent Memory, the system can provide more memory capacity in memory mode without persistence provided by the integrated flash storage. That flash storage can also be utilized with persistence in AppDirect mode and provides access to data closer to the CPU for improved performance on large datasets. I might as well cut that description short as Optane memory has already been discontinued. Do you think it was just too expensive or too complicated to implement? Seemed like a good idea at the time. Add a comment below if you have an opinion. Next, the switch tray has all 8 of the other PCI slots supported on the system and an AIOM module slot. It features a PCIe 4.0 switchboard for network communications. I will add the only other difference between that TNAR Plus and the TNAR without the Plus is the basic TNAR has a PCIe 3.0 bus for those PCI slots instead of PCIe 4.0. All in all, there are 10 PCI slots when you count the two up front located on the compute node. Those two also offer a PCIe 4.0 by 16 low profile slot. Those PCI slots can be outfitted with a number of options from Mellanox for ports and link throughput. Supported Mellanox controllers offer high data throughput and extreme low latency for AI, high-performance computing, and data-intensive infrastructures. You'll surely need that throughput to get the most out of that bank of 8 top-of-the-line NVIDIA A100 Tensor Core GPUs. This system is configured with a single ConnectX-5 NIC at 100 gigabit Ethernet with dual QSFP28 ports. ConnectX-6 cards are also supported and offer 200 gigabit Ethernet with single or dual port QSFP56 ports. ConnectX-7 with 400 gigs is perhaps a step too far, as those require a PCI 5.0 interface and this system tops out at PCI 4.0. There are also a number of options for that advanced I/O module on the far right at the back of the system for different ports and data throughput. Ours was configured with a 1 gigabit Ethernet advanced I/O module with two RJ45 ports, but it can also be outfitted with a Mellanox card offering two HDR 200 gigabit Ethernet QSFP56 ports. And there you have it, the Supermicro GPU SuperServer 420GP-TNAR Plus. If you're looking for a GPU server, there is a lot of wiggle room to support a number of workloads, depending on how it's configured. And with MIG supported on those GPUs, you can run a number of workloads simultaneously. If you want more information on this platform, I placed a link down below in the description, or you can hit that link right there. You can even configure a system to your specifications. itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Steumann with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.